So we'll get back to some more Pokemon Scarlet last time. We took down the Artisan Gym. Well, Brassius, or Yusuke, if you want to call him Yusuke. Head over to this weird tree in which we got Squirrelium from Banquass. If you're wondering about his XP, I used a couple of candies to get him up a level, so don't worry about that. It's not that crazy. If you really need to get him leveled up, just do a couple Terra Raid battles or just grind him a little bit. It's not that big of a deal. And to which, big a deal. Yeah, we are not supposed to be over here yet, at least the route I'm taking. But I'm going to go kill this Gimmigoo. I got the rare candy off of it. Okay, whatever. I'm going to go take down this Gimmigoo real quick. It's going to be a good source of XP anyway, so might as well do that right now. One-shot kill. But we will be heading to that city that we're seeing in the horizon at some point, but not for right now. 50 coins. And then I'm going to see if I can do some weirdo stuff. Okay, good. Tailwind. But yeah, there are Litleos here. If you really want to get a Litleo, that's another really good fire type. It's a fire normal type. Yeah, fire normal type. Which actually can be really good. Hey, shooting stars. I've never actually seen shooting stars in this game. Wow. If only it was like the shooting stars in Zelda. But anyway, I am going to head over here real quick. I do not want to go over there. That Team Star fight is really freaking tough. So don't do that right now. And why are there so many of these dudes? Okay. What's this? Drowsy. That's kind of a wasted Terra Raid battle if it's a Drowsy. Let me go heal up. Actually, what do you have to say? Zero trainers. Thanks. I forgot to fight that trainer over there, but we won't be over here for a little bit, so I'd like to heal my Pokemon. But another thing I forgot to mention with Terra Raid battles. Terra Raid battles are usually worth it to do simply because of the Terra typing. Because they are not locked to what the Pokemon in the raid battle can be. So for example, that Shroomish we got, that is a ground type specifically because of the raid battle. It wouldn't have that otherwise. So yeah, there is a way to change Terra types in the future, but don't worry about that right now. We won't be seeing that for quite some time. Anyway, where we want to head is actually back to the west. We want to start going up towards this Titan here. So I guess best case scenario would be, yeah, I guess going over to this side of Cortando. See you guys over there. After all of that, let's go pull out Squirrelium, and this is the cursed thing I wanted to show. Look how he runs! It's terrifying! I mean, they run away from you for the most part in, like, actual, you know, overworld spawns, but still, it's terrifying. Imagine that thing, like, running after you in your nightmares. Yeah, no. I got some Ghastlies here. Well, I guess I did hit that one. Squirrelium, what moves do you actually have? Mega Drain, Stun Spore, okay. Guess it's just Stun Spore? You're gonna lift me, bro. Of course, you... Ugh. Jackass! Alright, well, at least we can guarantee this to land. I'm just gonna try to catch it outright and see if I can do that. It's really annoying that you paralyzed me, bro. See if we can get you in a Pokeball. I need to start buying Pokeballs. One, a two, a three. Easy. I did say this, I think last episode. There is a way to get Gengar in this game without ever having to trade with real people. But again, we won't see that for quite some time, so I'll explain that when we get to it. There we go. I need to... Hello, Mankey. Well, first of all, I need to restore that paralysis because that's going to be annoying. Nice thing here is that we should be more leveled up than everybody else here. Second of all, I want to check our Pokedex because... got some S candies. Almost two. Oh, we need one more for the Firestone. Okay. Wait, is my... I think my set destination was still there. Alright, we'll get rid of that. Got some interesting Pokemon here. First of all, Rockruff. Very good pure rock type, surprisingly. I always rag on rock types for having way too many weaknesses for what they're good for, but Rockruff is kind of in the exception slot. It's a really good physical attacker. It's really fast. It learns a lot of different type of moves, such as Crunch. And it's just really good. It has three different evolutionary, well, forms. One is at night, one is at day, and one is at midday, which is really awkward to try to get. But if you get the midday form, it's actually a really nice looking Pokemon. You're going to be annoying. I don't want to one-shot this thing, so I'm going to just try to catch it with a Pokeball. I mean, we are technically over-leveled here, but we did go the right route. Please, man, I don't want to... Okay, you're going to be annoying. Gotta love accuracy and evasion. Great Ball? I'm pretty sure we can buy these now, actually, from the gym, from Pokemarts. 1, 2, 3, yay. So yeah, highly recommend Rockruff if you're planning on using, well, a rock type. It's a really good one. Rockruff. And plus, I mean, Lycanroc is just a really cool Pokemon. There we go. Hi, Mankey. Please don't punch me, sir. Okay, well, there's Mankey. Mankey was the one I was going to use before we ran into our shiny Pomade. Yeah, sorry, buddy. The reason why is because Mankey is actually really good in this game now. They gave Primeape an evolution, and it turns into a fighting ghost type of all things. Very interesting typing. This thing is a really good physical attacker. It's really fast. However, be aware that it does not learn a lot of different type of moves unless if it turns into its fully evolved form, which is, you know, the fire or the fighting ghost type. But before then, it primarily uses fighting type moves. It doesn't really get anything else besides that unless if you want to give it like Thunder Punch, Fire Punch, Ice Punch. But yeah, otherwise, it's a really good Pokemon. And like I said, I was going to use it on this LP before I ran into that shiny Palme, so I guess this thing is really mad at me for doing that. Man, you are really hitting me here. Please stay in the damn ball, you're low health. Oi, oi, oi. 1, 2, 3. Thank you, jackass. Jesus. Oi, oi, oi. Do not want to keep fighting that guy. But yeah, Pig Monkey. There we go. Into the box you go. Into which I need to heal up Squillium. Which, I still love that name. It's such a dumb name for it, I know, but I love it so much. It's the first thing that came to mind, because, I mean, it's a squid, man. I mean, he has legs, but it's a squid thing. And besides, I really like Tentacle and Hello, Rockruff. Let's go fight this dude. Yeray. Never heard of that name. Okay, this is a bad type matchup. I'm actually going to swap to Charge Bolt here. I mean, granted, it can't really do much unless it has fire, because we are neutral to that, I think. I don't think we're weak to flying, thankfully, on Squillium at least, so. There we go, let's take you down. One-shot kill. And, got some HP. Thanks, buddy. Level up on Tandemouse there. Still waiting to see if it just randomly evolves off-screen, because like I said, it just has a chance of doing that. But, yeah, weird. I thought I saw... Yeah, up here. This thing is weird as all hell. It's a weird baby chicken, Capsakid. Capsakid is odd. It evolves via Firestone. It's basically like a little jalapeno Pokemon. It is the only grass fire type in the entire game. Well, at least it turns into a grass fire. Evolves via Firestone. And it's a pretty interesting typing. It's very good offensively. Considering it can learn stuff like Giga Drain and Flamethrower at the same time, which is really cool, actually. I really like it. So, not going to use it on the team. We already have our grass type. Squillium is always better. But anyhow, it's still a good Pokemon. I recommend it. Capsaicid, spicy pepper. Into which I say, finally we get a grass fire type, because we wanted so... Well, was there... I don't think Sword and Shield had a grass fire type. If it did, I can't remember it. Hey, there's the Nimble! Into which I'm surprised I didn't use this on my team, considering it has, like, the first three letters of my actual, online name, not my real name. Nyman is not a real name, at least I know of. It's my online name, and, that's how I wish to be, referred to. Besides, most people call me by that name anyhow. Nimble, I think I explained, is a weird Pokemon. It's a pure bug type right now, but its evolved form turns into a bug dark type that's pretty defensive. It's kind of like a budget Scizor without the steel type. It's decent. I'd say try it out if you want to try something new or weird, but yeah, I just like that it's a grasshopper. We don't have a lot of grasshoppers, so... Here we go. I wish they made it into like a dark steel type though. I think that would have been better instead of bug tark. But there we go. Nimble. We will see its evolved form at some point, but not for a little bit. Anyway, we got another Nimble here. I thought it was shiny at first, but that... Knowing my luck, oh god, I got a Mudbray here. And a Phanpy! I'm not gonna go crazy with catching Pokemon right now, because we do want to go head up towards what's this one called? What am I? Titan, wait, no, what the hell is it called? Am I just blind? Open Sky. Yeah, Open Sky Titan. So as such, I'm not gonna go crazy about the Pokemon here. I will catch a bunch of them off screen, so... However, I will relegate this. Only areas that we're currently on or have already been to, and that we're not going back to, I will go back and catch Pokemon there. For example, like, the first route, you know, etc. But that route we were on where we got Toadstool, I don't think I'll mess with that route until we start heading over to that region again. So, simply because those Pokemon are... Well, they're around our level, and we were already over-leveled as it is, so... I don't want to go overkill with the levels. I try not to do that. I'm going to keep up that promise, hopefully. It's not my fault if I go to the intended route and get over-leveled, though. But, nonetheless, I will attempt to keep that under wraps, I guess. Although, if there's cool Pokemon I see that I really want, like that Phanpy... Then I'll go out of my way to catch him. And I actually... You know what? Screw it. I do want the Phanpy. Where are you, buddy? I don't know if you're a rare spawn here, especially since I've seen like three of you so far, but... Phanpy! It's just such a memorable Pokemon to me. I really don't want to kill you. Stun Spore, please. Caught off guard and couldn't move. That's perfect. Stun Spore. Because I know I'm going to one-shot it by accident if I use Mega Drain, so... Level 13, anyhow. It is going to be a war of attrition for you. I'm at least trying to get you to half health if I can. Maybe one more? Hopefully. The reason why I say I don't want to go out of my way and catch a bunch of Pokemon on screen is because it just takes up so much time. And I know people are not going to be wanting to sit here for, like, 20 years just me catching Pokemon... Especially like rare spawned Pokemon, so yeah, I will refrain from doing that. So, Draining Kiss. Yeah, no, I don't care. That Ralts is actually about to evolve here soon, so it's actually pretty nice. Phanpy lives nests in on a riverbank. There we go. Pretty cool. Pretty cool. Just keep heading down this route. It's really a quaint route. Let me go over here to get that TM while I'm at it here. Lots of other Pokemon. I probably should have gotten that Mudbray. Sunny Day. It's actually pretty good. Yeah, I probably should have gotten that Mudbray, but we'll get a chance for them later. They show up in a lot of different places, so it's not that imperative. Let's see. Lots of Ghastlies and stuff. This guy. This guy is weird. I was debating on using this, but I never decided to. Tadpole. It's a very odd Pokemon. I think that's a normal electric type? It's a tadpole. Hope I can confuse it, and I missed. Okay. Hi, Psyduck. What are you even doing on screen, buddy? Let's just try to hit this thing a couple times. But it's a really weird Pokemon. We won't see its evolved form for a little bit, but I would recommend it if you want to try something new or weird, but for my purposes, I think I'll leave it alone, especially since I already have an electric type, so. But it can join us in spirit. Tadbulb. There we go. Ella Tadpole. Oh, it's just pure electric. Okay. I thought it was electric normal. Game Freak really likes putting, like, or slapping normal typings on top of other Pokemon for no reason, so. That's why I'm used to guessing if it's that. You're a Caps Kid. We are going the right way. Okay, yeah, it's just a little while. Yeah, it's quite a little while. I mean, I could just ride on Coridon if I so wish. Which I actually made. Well, there's a trainer up ahead. I do want to keep these routes slow so I can, well, one, not miss any shinies in case there are a shiny. But along with that, new Pokemon and items and such like and the such. The wind goes whoosh. I'll believe you, I guess. Nazen. Very nasally. Venonats. I don't have a ground move, do I? No, I don't. I think I'm going to swap this over to... very awkward, because I don't have its weakness, but... Well, I do, but it's on a... Yeah, I'll just go Charge Bolt. It's going to be easier if I do that. The only bad thing with Toadstool right now is that he does not have a lot of good moves, but... We will get good moves on him at some point. He's actually about to evolve here soon, too. I think he evolves at level 30. Also, I forgot you had Confusion. You're a dick. What is with my luck and always getting confused by stuff that, you know, I wish I didn't get confused by? I'll just go Bite, and it's going to do more damage. Please hit. Okay, thank you. Almost a one-shot. Crit. Now, if I got the flinch, that'd be even better. Up to say... Oh, come on! You are an ass. Also, why is that Mudbray just looking at us like that? Like, he's got his head turned and just weirded out. That's funny. Please, no. Well, at least I didn't use Dig. Poison. Man, you are an asshole. Stop putting all these ailments on top of me. I don't even think there's a Pokemon Center here. At least soon. And holy crap, you can actually see the Titan from here. If you look towards the windmills, holy crap, I didn't even know you could see it from here. That's very surprising. I guess good job on the render distance. Man, can that Mudbray just stop looking at me like that? Looks like a pissed off horse. I mean, granted, Mudbray is a horse with a bowl cut, so I would be mad too. You're no fair. Don't stop my whooshing. Whoosh! Alright, yeah, when's the next Pokemon Center here? Oh, right up the road, actually. Okay. Let's ride. Pokeball. What's this? Oh, wait, no, there's a healing station right here. Thank God. Did not want to talk to whatever that is. I can't even see it. Capsakid? No. You are an asshole. It was a Sinistee. Okay, running away. I have no business with you. I do not care. Screw you and everything you stand for. All right. Picnic. Give me your ingredients. And I need to heal. You gave me apples, bananas, and yogurt. And whipped cream. Alright, well, thanks, buddy. You got another new Pokemon over here. I really don't like this thing. Yeah, Flittle. It's really weird. It's a pure psychic type, I believe. It's just a really odd Pokemon, because its evolved form turns into an ostrich. I don't know how either, but yeah, it's just a really... It's regarded as a UFO Pokemon, which in which case, why didn't it evolve into a UFO instead of a ostrich? I don't know. It's not that great either. It's not a good psychic type, per se, because I think it's mostly physical. And there's just better options. I wouldn't recommend Flittle in its evolved form, but I digress. That's your choice if you wish to do that. The Frill Pokemon. Oh, I thought it was the UFO Pokemon. Never mind. Well, Frill. There we go. Pokedex has been updated. Let's grab this. And then we can go check what this is over here. Oh, what are you? Is that a Buizel or a Floatzel? I think it's a Buizel. I don't know what Terra type is, so I don't... Oh, actually, I think I know what it is. It's Ice. Yeah, screw it. Let's go for it. Let's take you down. Yeet. I'm pretty sure this turns into an Ice Terastalize. Yep, I remembered right. If you're going for Buizel, I would actually grab this thing, because it eventually learns Ice Fang. And while Ice is a pretty, defensively weak typing, it's weak to like 7 other types, I would say it's good specifically for its Ice Fang. So, yeah, I think it probably has Ice Fang right here. No, it has Bite. So yeah, I'm not going to catch it personally because, well, I already have a water type. And yeah, you can see right there, you can't outright kill a Terastalized Pokemon like this immediately. The game will just not let you. Can you stop hitting him for 4 times? I mean, I appreciate it, but it would have been nice earlier. At least you got some HP back. And now it's going to go turn back into a water type. I mean, this isn't the only place you can go and get a Buizel with an Ice-type Terastalization, but this is probably the more guaranteed way. And these guys do respawn after some time, so... There you go. I'm not keeping it, I could care less. But hey, it's there if you want it. Level up on Squillium. Which case... Swapping back. What are you? Are you a Chewtle? Yeah, you're a Chewtle, I already have you. Or do I have you? Yeah, I do. Okay. I always keep thinking that Chewtle's, like, normal colors are its shiny form, but its shiny form makes it green. Which, I don't know. I would think it'd be the opposite, but... Hey, Rare Bone. I has Red Air Bone, and hey, you got some Basculin down there. I won't bother them right now. Can you please get out of my way so I can get this Gimme Ghoul? Thank you. What is this? Okay, so we got Rock. Rock what? Swablu. I can probably do that later. You can grab Swablu later, but let's go fight this guy. We are starting to run low on time, so. I'm hitchhiking. What was your name again? Aesir. Well, you're definitely not Norse. And hello, Fungus. There's a Fungus among us. God, again, awkward friggin' Pokemon. Ugh. I do have a fire type planned for the team, but we won't be seeing it for a little bit. So right now, it's just going to be awkward and having Praeus do everything for us. And this is a really awkward swing. Like, can I get, like, a better angle? I guess this is... What if I... Wow, the camera will just say, screw you, no. What if I, like... I mean, that's fine. Wing attack. One-shot kill. Well, like I said, we will go and get a fire type at some point in the future, just not for the moment. But hey, at least we can deal with, other things through Squillium, although Squillium needs a ground type move, like, desperately. Pokedex has been updated. Okay, yeah, that Tandabounce is still doing his thing. Or I guess there. It's technically 2 Pokemon. Let's go grab this. Boink. And then there is a Pokemon Center right here. I think I will go back and get that Swablu. This is where the next Titan is, but we're not going to have enough time to take care of it this episode. And why is that star super shiny? Okay, that's cool detail, I guess. Let's go heal up, first and foremost. Because it's been a while. Well, not a while since we've seen a Pokemon Center, but... Well, actually, yeah, it has. It's just we healed up on the way here from the picnic person. Very nice indeed. There we go. Okay, I'm going to put Prayus in the lead. I know I keep putting Prayus in the lead for a lot of stuff that requires, you know, hard-hitting stuff, but trust me, in the future, we will get... okay, I just really wanted this Pokemon. There we go. In the future, the other team members will have their moments to shine, quite literally, for one of them. But, you know, for right now, I think I'll just go take down this Swablu. Let's go do it. I think I might have made a mistake. Is this rock or steel? Okay, no, it is rock. For some reason, I always get the rock symbol and the steel symbol mixed up. Because they look very similar. But no, I got it right this time. Hey, the Intimidate, though. Alright, let's do Aqua Jets. And yeah, we'll just Aqua Jet to victory. This thing's weak to it. We shouldn't have anything to worry about. And hey, there's a crap... is it Crabrawler? Yeah, Crabrawler, because its false form is crab abominable. Anyway, Swablu is actually a really good Pokemon. Oh, okay, we killed it on like two turns. Swablu is actually a really good Pokemon. Flying Dragon type, it specializes in being very defensive. It does learn stuff like Dragon Breath and stuff like that, but I mean, it is a good Pokemon, especially in Gen 3. So, let's go get you. There we go. Swablu is ours. Terra Raid battles are also really good for getting Pokemon that you don't generally see till later, so... Hence the Swablu. We will see Swablu here soon, but... Like that Shroomish we got, we don't see Shroomish for a little bit either. Now, don't be afraid if you're thinking that I will get team members from Terra Raid battles. That I am outlawing, because that's really cheap to try to get an early on team member through a Terra Raid. It'd be the equivalent of, like, trading over all my Pokemon I'm going to use for the, you know, playthrough. And that's just really lame, so I'm not going to do that. So don't worry. Don't worry. Anyway, let's head back up to the Pokemon Center. Nice thing is about Terra Raid Battles, too, is that your Pokemon gets fully healed. At least the one that's in your lead, so... That's pretty nice. Anyway, let's go back to... Actually, everyone's around the same level. I'll just keep Charge Bolt for right now, but... I'm gonna end things off here. Next, okay, rough jump scare. Next time on Pokemon Scarlet, we'll be heading over towards the windmills to fight the Open Sky Titan. I will see you guys in the next one. Take care.